Welcome to Success Series Webinars. This webinar is brought to you by Louisiana State Civil Service.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to Success Series. Can you guys believe this is our last episode of 2022?
Right. Time is flying.
Time is flying by so fast. And let me tell you, we're so grateful that you guys are here with us today. You know, we started off the year talking about exploring courage, finding our courage. And then we use that courage to try out new things, to figure out what our niche is. And then once we figured out what our niche was, we decided, okay, now we have to network. Let's grow our niche. And it brings us to this episode where it shows us how grateful we are, how far we've come over the year. And so with that being said, you guys guessed it, our topic is all about growing in gratitude. So we want to see how much we've grown over the year. So my name is Kimberly Broussard, and I'm just one of your hosts today.
I'm Nathan Barnaba, co-host of Success Years Webinars.
And my name is Tara Gallup. I will be your producer, the person behind the screen in your chat.
So let's see how far we've grown over the years, you guys. I want to ask you a couple of questions, and Tara is going to be dropping those questions in chat as well. So it brings us to our next segment. Where are we now? All right, Nathan. I have a couple of questions for you, okay? All right, so tell me, what is one way that you've embraced courage this year?
I think one way is that I networked. If anybody knows me, networking is like my weakness, but I actually stepped out of my shell a lot this year and met people, built relationships, and I'm glad that I did that. Mm-hmm. What about you?
I think one way that I've explored courage now, networking is my area of growth. So I haven't joined any, networking clubs or anything, but I do find that I'm pushing myself. I take baby steps. So I've been trying to tell everyone good morning and, you know, good afternoon. And when people get off the elevator, so I've been trying to interact with people more. What about you, Tara?
You know, I said yes to a lot of things this year. I started going to a graduate program. I started going to grad school, and I also said yes to sitting on a board for a local organization. And that took a lot of courage because it was a lot of change all at one time. All right. Oh, we've got some good answers in the chat. Reed said that he asked for help. He started asking for help when he needs help with any tasks, big or small. Rana says she's been working on being the bigger person with loved ones and just spreading love. Christy wrote a book that was out of her comfort zone. And if you guys don't know Christy, she has written a lot of books. Mm-hmm. And she said this one was out of her comfort zone. And she talked about feelings. Artie has also worked on networking as well. Brittany's trying different new things. There's all kinds of great answers. And people have been, taking some courageous steps this year.
And I'm excited about that. I have another question. Have you tried anything new? If so, what was it?
It was saying yes to things that scared me. Mm. Like putting myself in the spotlight. Because, you know, at first, that anxious feeling where you don't want to do it. But I realized that once you jump in and after it's done, it's like, okay, why was I scared? Mm-hmm. So that was my biggest thing this year. What about you?
I think something new that I tried this year is this format. What were you doing right now? I'm usually one who's not open to change. And, you know, I reframed my mindset for 2022 at the beginning. And I was like, you know, let's just try it. And our wonderful crew did a lot of convincing. And I'm so glad that, you know, we made that decision. So, you know, this is where stepping out of your comfort zone pays off. What about you, Tara?
Yeah, something new. They asked me to sit behind the screen and become a sort of producer role. I've never worked with videos, never worked with tech outside of just owning my own, you know, cell phones and apps and all of that. So for me, this whole thing is new, and I've learned a lot about technology in the process, which is awesome. I also want to share, Ardia said she's been volunteering more, being more helpful, more approachable. And that is something I would love to start trying.
Me too. I definitely would love to start doing. Maybe that'll be our goals for 2023. All right. So what's one way that you've tried building trust in your relationship?
I would have to say being more empathetic. I think that helps build relationships, because you never know what people are going through, mm-hmm. and showing empathy, it's kind of meeting them where they are.
I think one way that I've started to tried building trust in my relationships is to be present, mm-hmm. Not letting my mind get distracted, giving them my undivided attention, mm-hmm. and show them that I'm actually listening, and I find that it's been working very well for me. What about you, Tara?
You know, this is something that I'm still consistently working on. And I think that I agree quite a bit with what is going on in this chat. The first one that came through was from Rhonda, and she said, she's worked on being a better listener. And that's something that I really have been trying to work on as well. Ardia says, letting go of the past has helped build more trust, being more vulnerable for Mariah. Reed says, following through with what he says he would do. And really just overall sharing, multiple people are sharing, actively listening, being present, agreeing, showing more empathy. And Anne-Marie, this is a great one. Do not let past experiences influence negatively on current relationships.
Ooh, that is
wow.
That's a gem.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so one more question for you guys. And, you know, our topic is all about growing in gratitude. Mm-hmm. So I want to know, what are you guys grateful for?
Well, you know, you touched on something earlier about the new format. And I think you could agree that we're both grateful for our staff behind the scenes. Mm-hmm. So we have Lacey Talley and Jenny Creighton and Julie Miller, who isn't here. But we're truly grateful for them. They really helped set up this success series webinar and took it to a new level.
Mm-hmm. They're the magic behind the scenes. Yes. They've been working so diligently to make sure that, you know, everything runs smoothly, and, you know, we are very grateful for them.
We are. And they only wanted to show themselves for a second, but you guys cannot imagine how much they actually do for us. So thank you to our behind the scenes crew. And we have some really, really wonderful things that people are grateful for, including family, working with their coworkers, great friends, improvement in health, and consistency, intention, working through it. There's a lot of things to be grateful for this year.
Mm-hmm. And most importantly, we are definitely grateful for you guys tuning in, you know, every episode, sharing your best practices, sharing your challenges, being vulnerable with us. You know, you guys have been along, you know, every step of the way with us, and we could not, you know, have done all of this without you guys. So we're very grateful for you. And so with that being said, you know, we're going to be talking about growing in gratitude. And, you know, before we dive into, you know, all of the things that come along with it, you know, I want us to, you know, have a working definition that we're going to, you know, use throughout these episodes. So the formal definition of gratitude is a conscious, positive emotion one can express when feeling thankful for something, whether tangible or intangible. So listening to that definition, in your own words, Nathan, what does gratitude mean to you?
I would have to agree with the definition, but I would also have to say that gratitude is including the big and little things. Because, you know, sometimes we overlook the small things in life and they go unnoticed, but they play a pivotal life in our lives, pivotal part in our lives.
Right.
Do you have one? Or
it's basically, you know, being thankful. Thankful for the things that, you know, we have and don't have. I think, you know, gratitude is basically changing your mindset from the glass half empty to the glass half full. What about you, Tara?
You know, I agree. And I think for me, it's all about making sure to take the time to actually sit in it and acknowledge it. One of the big things that I always think about is that we kind of share with our friends and families, oh, you know, I'm thankful for you. And of course I'm grateful for this, but it's taking the time to actually say it out loud and actually sit with it and mention it, even if it's just for an hour on a random Tuesday in December, taking the time to acknowledge it. And so far we have quite a few. See, Diana says being thankful and showing appreciation. So being kind, making sure to share that appreciation, as well as Jennifer says, showing appreciation in the way that the person likes without expecting anything in return. So not just how you would show it, but what they need in order to know that they are being appreciated.
All right. Well, I mean, we have some gems in the chat today. Right. You guys are bringing it, in the year. So now that, we have our working definition, I think it's time for us to test our knowledge, right? So it brings us to our next segment. You guys remember, it's fact or fiction. Tara, I think we have a couple of questions,
We do. We have some pretty good ones for us. So the way this works, if you weren't here for our last fact or fiction, is in just a moment, I am going to launch a poll for you. So your job in the chat is to go ahead and share. I'm going to read off a statement, and your job is to share whether you think it is fact or fiction. All right, let's get started with our very first one. So we have gratitude has an impact on your mood. Fact or fiction? Kim, what do you think?
I think it's fact, because should I say now, or should I wait for the answer? I feel like, gratitude is a mindset, and I did think that it could impact your mental state. So Nathan, I'm curious, what's the answer?
What does our audience say?
Our audience is 100% in favor of fact.
So our audience is actually right. It is a fact.
Woo!
So scientific studies found that people who show gratitude and appreciation were happier than those that don't.
Yeah, and I have to add, we got a comment in the chat that Dara says, she says it just glows from the inside.
Ooh,
yes.
That's such a warm feeling. I love it. All right, let's go to our next fact or fiction. Gratitude can affect blood pressure.
What do you think?
Well, it can impact your mood. So I'm assuming it could impact your blood pressure as well.
Are you sure? Final answer?
No, I'm nervous. Yes, I think it's a fact. What does the audience say, Tara?
The audience majority, 96% of you, say that it is a fact. I got 4% saying it's fiction.
Okay.
Nathan?
So it is a fact. So studies found that people who show gratitude have reduced blood pressure, but not only that, they have less chronic pain, increased energy, and they live longer.
You had me at increased energy. I definitely need some energy.
I'm with you there. 100%. All right. Fact or fiction number 3. You guys ready?
Mm-hmm.
We have gratitude has no impact on how we view ourselves. Fact or fiction?
I'm going to go with fiction.
Has no impact on how we view ourselves. Audience.
I have to ask again, are you sure?
He's making me second guess my answers.
Maybe you should or shouldn't.
I think it's fiction. What is everybody else?
I think, Nathan, you might be impacting what they think because the numbers keep changing. All right, so 94% of our audience thus far believes that it is fiction.
So it actually is fiction. So gratitude can boost self-esteem by over 30%.
Wow.
This may be because when you intentionally notice the ways and things that you're grateful for and the way others treat you, you have a better sense of your own value. So you know your worth.
I can see that.
All right, I like it. Number 4. Gratitude can shift your mindset. Fact or fiction?
Are you sure? I have to keep asking if she's sure.
It's my final answer.
And the audience 100% agrees that it is fact.
Yeah.
But they are on it today because that is a fact.
Woo-hoo.
So grateful people are more prone to positive thinking. They look for the positive side of life rather than the negatives.
All right, our last one, we have grateful people have more friends than those who are not grateful. So being grateful means that you might have a little more friends than those who choose not to practice gratitude. Fact or fiction?
No, I'm thinking fact.
Fact? Really?
Don't follow me, guys. Don't follow me.
So you think that if you are more grateful, it might lead to having more friends.
Right.
Okay. It looks like now this is a closer one than the others. It looks like the audience agrees with about 86% of you believing it is fact. Nathan?
Yes, that is definitely a fact. So gratitude makes us nicer, more trusting, and more social. And as a result, it helps us make more friends and deepen our existing relationships.
Well, I tell you what, I mean, just the benefits alone for fact or fiction, it's making me want to, you know, start implementing that gratitude right. daily. I mean, it's going to give me more energy. It's going to get me a lot of friends. It's going to help me lower my blood pressure. I mean, that's amazing.
Right.
All right. Well, thank you guys for playing that. That was fun. So thank you, Nathan. Thank you, Tara. That was fun. So, you know, we know that practicing gratitude can impact your life in more ways than we can count. And so, you know, we want to help you guys give you some strategies to help you start implementing gratitude in your everyday life. So, Nathan, you're in the spotlight right now because I know that you've been practicing gratitude for quite a while. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, I have a couple of questions and I'm sure the audience has a couple of questions in regards to gratitude. And my first question is, you know, why do you feel that gratitude is so important to implement?
So I feel like it's important because it helps you kind of reground yourself. Mm-hmm. So much times we can go through life, bad things might happen to us or, you know, experiences that we forget to actually be grateful for the things that are going right or things that didn't happen.
Right.
So, you know, one of my friends, Christy Atwood, you guys know her. She said something about be grateful for things that didn't happen. You didn't get hit by a bus today. You didn't, you know, it's showing appreciation for the things that, you know, that you should be grateful for, big or small.
So big or small. So why do you think that it's important to not only, because when we think of gratitude, I think of, you know, the big things, mm-hmm. being grateful for, you know, the big things that we have. Why is it also important for us to be grateful for the smaller things?
Because in my experience, the smaller things often go overlooked. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I'm grateful for the air that I breathe, but sometimes I might not say that I'm grateful for it. I might be grateful for my last vacation. You mm-hmm. know what I mean? Like it's, yeah. pivotal things that help us in our life that we sometimes just don't even notice or we pay it dust.
Mm. And I, you know, when you said that, that's why I had to ask that question, because, you know, too often we forget about the small things. Mm-hmm. I think you said something as small as the air that we breathe. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we don't think about the small stuff. We focus on the big stuff. Mm-hmm. So what made you start implementing gratitude into your everyday life? Was it something, was there a turning point in your life? Did something happen? Like what caused you to say, you know, I'm going to start practicing this?
Yes. So I guess I think it was 2016 or 2017. I had just graduated college and I was at my last job. And I found myself turning into a Grinch. Like I just wasn't happy. I was complaining. As soon as I would have the Sunday scaries, I wouldn't want to go to work on Monday. I was just so in that negative mindset. Mm. And a friend of mine actually pointed it out that, you know, Nathan, you aren't happy. You're changing. Like, what's going on? And that's whenever I took a step back and he actually recommended a YouTube audiobook, The Power of Positive Thinking.
Right.
And after I listened to that book, it kind of changed my mind to actually want to look into gratitude more, to practice gratitude more, because your thoughts can change things. Mm-hmm. And me being in that negative space, not wanting to go to work, complaining all the time, it really affected who I was as a person. And I didn't like that.
Right. And so you said that you were someone, you know, identified these things in you and made that mm-hmm. recommendation, right? Are there like signs besides, you know, the Sunday blues and, you know, complaining? Are there other signs that we could recognize within ourselves mm-hmm. to that can help us identify if we should start practicing gratitude? Or is that something that everybody should practice no matter if, you know, what headspace you're in?
I I would have to, I'm split on that. I think everybody should practice it just because of the benefits, the health benefits and all the things. But also the signs are, you're just, if you pay attention, you'll notice, for example, like whenever you're around someone who complains all the time, do you like being around that person?
That's a negative.
Exactly. So it's that effect. You kind of, whenever you become that person that everybody avoids, then I think it's a sign that you should try to practice gratitude and just pay attention to the signs. That'll actually help you realize that you need to practice gratitude.
Right.
It's always the sign.
And we have so many outside influences. Like, you know, social media could definitely drain you and, you know, impact your mental health and things of that nature. And so, you know, practicing gratitude, you know, with all the benefits that we talked about, I don't see, you know, the downside of implementing it, you know, even if you're starting off small.
Yeah.
And so with that being said, you know, how do you practice gratitude, or how has practicing gratitude impacted your life?
I would definitely say that I'm more happier. My mental health has improved. Like, I, being in that space of depression and not wanting to go to work, I'm actually more receptive, more happy. It shifted my mindset to always being appreciative of the good things.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I might not have a Ferrari, but I have a car. You know, it's things like looking back into the things that you do have and making sure that what you do have is enough.
Right.
It's reassuring that.
Right. Tara, I know also that you practice gratitude as well. You want to share, either comment on what Nathan has said, or you want to share some of how it's impacted your life as well?
I do. And I have a lot of comments to get to as well. I promise we will bring those up. But to your question, Kim, I think for me is, with so many things going on in life and just how busy we are from day to day with our multiple processes, practices, our groups, our school, our, you know, work, you know, family life, personal life, whatever you have going on, it is so easy for me to fall into, well, I didn't have time for this, and I didn't get to this, and this is negative. And it's so easy to, you know, kind of succumb to all of the negative, or the, you know, I guess what feels like drowning parts of your life. Mm-hmm. And when you take a step back and you take a step back to think about gratitude, it reminds you that life is life, and you don't have to get stuck in those negative pieces.
Right.
You know, it's a balance, and being able to kind of ebb and flow through, you know, the different parts of it and still keep that positive mindset and attitude, like you said, even when you're at a, you know, a little lower point or, you know, a busy season, that's really helpful. And, you know, to your first question about why is gratitude important, I really wanted to share some of these because it really is amazing that you guys are thinking this way. It helps you see all that's going well. The more positive and grateful you can see things, the happier you will feel when life gets challenging. That's what Reed said. Dara said, sometimes we can learn to be grateful for our challenges or trials, because at the end we've grown and we've become stronger and than we ever thought we could be. Or even make our relationships deeper and closer. I know we've been talking a lot about relationships this year, so that's really great for me to hear that. And then, never mind. Tasha got it for us, but they were asking what the name of that ebook you shared. So it's The Power of Positive Thinking on YouTube. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Power of Positive Thinking on YouTube. Great. Oh, wow. Even Kimberly shared as well, when you express gratitude towards others, it helps them feel good about themselves too.
Mm-hmm.
I like that.
And, you know, even I know around the holidays, a lot of people, you ever heard of holiday blues? Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes, you know, that holiday blues kind of seeps in, and, you know, what, you know, better way to try and combat that with, you know, having that, you know, practicing that grateful mindset. And again, it's just starting off small and working your way up. And I think Nathan, you know, has some great tips for that. And so tell me, how do you practice gratitude?
So I'm not sure if you're familiar with Rhonda Byrne. She is the law of attraction guru. but she bases her work around being grateful for things, because whenever you're grateful for things, you're in the receptive mood for more things to be grateful for. And she wrote a book, The Secret is Nice. You know, it talks about gratitude, but her second book is actually, it's called The Magic. And what The Magic does is that it has 28 gratitude practices. Mm-hmm. And what I like about the book is that it helps keep you accountable. So if, let's say I'm on day 4 and I miss a day, I have to go back to day 1. Mm-hmm. So what the practices do is it makes you more grateful. It makes you appreciate things because the activities in the book are so just, they get you thinking.
Right.
Now I do have some tips to share if you don't have any questions.
Oh, well, actually, I do have a quick question, because we talk a lot about gratitude and being grateful for the things around you. Mm-hmm. And I think, Tara, you said, you know, one of the comments in there was about self-gratitude as well. And so how do you show gratitude to yourself?
Mm. Definitely self-care. Mm-hmm. I do my best to participate in self-care, whether it's going for a walk or maybe getting a pedicure. It's just making sure that I know that I'm grateful for myself. Mm-hmm. I'm grateful for my progress. Well, things don't always work out, whether it's I didn't meet a goal or so, but I learned something in that lesson. Just like someone said in the comments, challenges, they help us grow.
Right. And so how important or why is it important for you to, you know, when you're practicing gratitude, to also implement things, some that self-care and that self-gratitude?
Because we can also lose ourselves sometimes. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we don't always see our worth or who we are to ourselves. Going back to the self-esteem, we see the science says that grateful people have higher self-esteem. So why not put it towards ourselves?
Right. Tara, what are some things that you do to practice that self-gratitude?
You know, Kim, I am working on that. That's something that I have really tried to make a priority out of this year. And it's still very much work in progress, but I have started, you know, making sure that I get the sleep that I need and making sure that I take the time, even when I'm stressed out, even when I've got a lot on my plate. My supervisor, Julie, she's actually part of our behind the scenes team. She always says, you know, what her biggest thing is, you know, what's the worst thing that could happen? Mm-hmm. She's got a funnier way of saying it. I don't know if I should say on the air, but it, essentially the biggest thing is the worst thing that can happen really that impactful, mm-hmm. or is it just an inconvenience? Mm-hmm. And if it's just an inconvenience and, you know, you need to do something, you know, whatever the worst thing is, that inconvenience is not worth you sacrificing your self-gratitude or your mental health, then do what you need to do to take care of yourself. So for instance, you know, a lot of times I have a lot of work to get done on my personal time that's, you know, not work related. Like I mentioned, I was in grad school and on a board and all of that. This year I made sure to not stress so hard about some of those things. And if I needed to take a break or I needed to go to sleep instead of staying up all night cramming, I went to sleep.
Right.
And the impact it had on my, really my grades, but just the way that I felt about myself and the mm-hmm. situation, it boosted a lot in its work. So focusing on my sleep, focusing on, you know, doing self-check-ins, that's mm-hmm. something that I have been working on. Man, this chat is blowing up and I love it. As far as ways that others are practicing gratitude and self-gratitude is noticing the good thing, showing appreciation. That came from Diana. Karen's shared that she has a gratitude journal. So she makes sure to thank people for things, write in her journal, and tell her coworkers they're awesome. So sometimes people just need to know when they're awesome. I love it. Reed shares that he's always tried to be there for people, be a friendly face if they need. Diana says sharing gratefulness daily. Rhonda has a daily journal as well. Maybe we got a lot of gratitude journals. I didn't know that was a thing. Mm-hmm. Is that a thing?
I love that.
I've never heard it, but I really, really enjoy it. And just some quiet time. Ooh, affirmations of gratitude in a mirror. Mm-hmm. You guys ever done that where you self-talk to yourself in a mirror? Mm. I like that.
That's a good one.
I do the affirmations in the mirror. Mm-hmm. I do those. And you know, I that practicing that self-gratitude also helps with that negative self-talk.
Mm-hmm.
And it helps combat that. Mm-hmm. That's why I think that, you know, it's so important to try and implement some kind of strategy to make sure that you are grateful for the things that you've done and who you are. And something that I do, and I think I've shared this before, is, you know, at my desk, I have I call it my positivity board. Mm-hmm. And so all of my accomplishments, things that I've done, little notes that sweet notes that coworkers have given me, I have it on my positivity board. And it's right next to me for a constant reminder that when I, you know, start to feel like, oh, I am such and such an age, I'm not going to give you all my age. And, you know, I haven't accomplished all that I want to accomplish in life, and that, you know, I'm not where I want to be in life. Or, you know, I have that constant reminder that, you know, hey, you've come a long way. Look how you've grown. Look what you've done. You know, it's a constant reminder. And that's what I love about it. So with that being said, Nathan, so for those of our audience or that are out there that don't know where to start or how to begin to implement this gratitude into our daily lives, do you have some tips that you can share with us?
Yes. So basically, I just want to say that there's no one way to give gratitude. Like you can take, so for example, what I did with Rhonda Byrne was I took her tips on giving gratitude, her practices, and I kind of put my own twist on them and made it my own. So it's okay to kind of make your own process of giving gratitude as long as you are feeling the benefits of it. Mm. So one thing I wanted to share was count your blessings. So one thing that I do in the morning is that I write down 10 things that I'm grateful for and why. Mm. And at first, I know I wasn't doing the why, but the why helped because it helps you have a better understanding of why you're grateful. It kind of, it helps that impact. It helps that shift to be grateful for. Mm. And after you write down those 10 things, read it back to yourself out loud and say, thank you, thank you, thank you, 3 times. And it's like you feel a shift in your mood. Mm. And I even noticed that it kind of sets the tone for my day whenever I give gratitude and say the things that I'm grateful for.
10 things, huh? Mm-hmm. Tara, can you come up off the top of your head with 3 things that you're grateful for?
3 or 10?
Uh-huh. 3.
Oh, I thought she was asking me for 10. And I was like, not today, not today. I am grateful for, you know what, this week, I am very grateful for my coworkers and their, you know, just pure, genuine attitudes and, you know, relationships that they have with me and that I, you know, work to build with them. I am grateful that we are close to the holiday season and I'm taking a little time off, y'all. I need it. And I'm excited for that. I'm grateful for that. And I'm grateful for the time that I will have off with family that I don't get to see very often. So that is exciting for me. What about y'all? Do y'all have 3 things?
Yes, I think I have 3 things. You know, when he said 10, I was like, 10? 10 is a lot, but 3, I can definitely, one, I'm definitely grateful for my coworkers, this team, and I get to wake up every day and do something that I really love, and not a lot of people can say that, and so I'm definitely grateful, you know, that I get to work with such a phenomenal team that, you know, you guys are amazing. And I also am very thankful for my family, and I am definitely thankful for my health. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it was easy for Tara and I to come up with, you know, 3 things. So if you can't make the 10 list, are there questions or things that you can ask yourself to help you come up with the 10 list?
Yes. And also, like, at first you might think of the big things, like, I'm grateful that I'm grateful that I went to China last year or things, but eventually you're going to have to get to those small things. Mm. And that's when you start looking around at the things that's what's around you. That's whenever you get grounded. That's whenever, like, when I can't think of 10 things, I'm like, okay, well, I'm grateful for the lights that I'm looking at right now. I'm grateful for my gratitude journal. I'm grateful for my cell phone because it helps me communicate. So that's when you start finding those small things to add up to your list and help you meet those 10 things.
Right.
And also, if you can, it takes practice. Mm-hmm. You can also make your own rules, do 5, start out small. So that way you can grow.
can grow. Tara, I think you have some comments in chat.
I do. So speaking of, you know, ways to practice gratitude, as well as, you know, making up your own rules and finding somewhere to start, this chat is blowing up with ideas. Christy had shared that one way she shares her gratitude during the holidays is to overtip people in food industries. And she carries around, so financially, if you can afford it, she carries around a couple of larger bills for people who make her smile in service industries. And a lot of people agreed with that. They like to surprise people in drive-thrus randomly, share an act of kindness, then pay for someone's coffee maybe. And there's just so many, and I'm having to scroll through all of these. Rhonda says, just being kind to everybody that you, be intentional about being kind to everyone you come across that day. Karen says she, one of the things she does to practice gratitude year round with that random act of kindness is that same, not just during the holidays, but year round, gift bag or fruit basket to their church's homebound or elderly members. Stacy says that she has cards, so like, you know, note cards that she has that people have given her tacked on the wall in her office.
Okay.
So she keeps being able to glance and remember the gratitude others gave her, which allows her to practice that for herself as well.
Yes.
And there's just so many. And I love that people are starting to list the things that make them feel grateful, or the things that they feel grateful for. So not everybody struggles with coming up with 10, and I am so glad, so glad.
So Nathan, I know you told us about making sure that we start off our morning and write down 10 things that we're grateful for. What are some other steps that you'd recommend?
Another practice I have that has really helped me was write a thank you note to three people that have impacted your life. You know, we also sometimes we can take people for granted.
Right.
And writing down a thank you note, it kind of helps improve that relationship because you kind of recognize people's value. But and it also just it sets the tone for y'all's relationship.
Right. You know, we always talk about giving people their flowers while they're, you know, while they're in your life. And what better way to do that than to, you know, write those three thank you notes and give that to, you know, the people who have impacted your life.
And another thing about the list is that you don't always have to give it to someone, maybe, you know, and to make it more difficult. This has really helped me was actually include one person that you don't talk to anymore. Think about how they benefited your life. It could be, you know, somebody's not in your life no more, a relationship that just kind of fizzled out. But write out that thing and you'll notice that you'll start to change on the situation and you'll be more grateful. It's like writing out those feelings.
That is such a great recommendation.
And don't give it to them.
And
I would not give it to them.
Okay. I'm glad you clarified that. That is definitely important. Tara, did you want to comment on that?
When Nathan said, I want to make it more difficult, I was like, what? It's already difficult. But wow, that is such that like blew my mind is write to somebody or maybe a situation even that isn't part of who you are anymore. I just want to thank you for that comment because that is something that really blew my mind. And you know, a lot of people, the thank you note idea, and I want to share, I love this journal idea from the chat. Apparently a gratitude journal is a thing. I had never heard of it, so thank you guys for sharing that with us because I think I might start one.
I definitely want to implement one in 2023. I started and I stopped, but I'm going to start again because I do see the benefits of, you know, growing in gratitude and I see how it's impacted, you know, your life. And, you know, when I am like an Eeyore, you're like, hey, you're always there to show me the positives and, you know, change my mind frame. So I appreciate that. I think you have one more strategy for us, right?
Yeah. So my last strategy is to find a gratitude symbol. It can be an animal. And Rhonda Byrne, she talks about a rock, but I actually have an animal. So it's a butterfly. And anytime I see a butterfly, I could be driving, walking, it could be on TV. I'll stop in that thought and stop to be grateful, to give thanks. And what it does, it reminds you to set the tone and just be grateful and appreciate things. Nice. So it really, really helps. If you could pick a symbol, what would it be?
Maybe a cardinal.
Okay.
I see them sometimes when I take my daily walks, and they're just so beautiful. Like it just warms my heart when I see one. I'm like, oh. So I think that's what I would pick. What about you, Tara? What would you pick?
Oh, man. There's a lot of symbols. I might have to say a star. And I don't know that I have a real reason for it, but I just, stars are kind of a recurrence in my life. And, you know, it's a symbol. Really, it reminds me of my mom. Her name is Starling. Nobody calls her Star, but it just reminds me of her and the recurrence of that. And I think just seeing a star would remind me to be grateful of, you know, all that is out there in outer space,
right?
As well as my mother. And in the chat too, we've got red cardinals and butterfly, quite a few people with butterflies. Christy surprise is a cat. Rhonda said a bird feather. And I have to point out a comment because it made me smile, you guys. Keitra shared that she is reflecting that she is grateful for us and this series, and that you know, your conversations and our guest stars and all of that have stretched our mindsets this year, and she didn't even realize it, and said that she shared that with others. And the only reason why I read that out loud, Keitra, is because we want to say thank you and grateful we are for you participating, because we wouldn't be here if it weren't for you guys joining us every time.
Right. I mean, thank you so much, Nathan, for, you know, being in the spotlight right now and sharing, like seriously sharing, you know, all of the strategies and the how-tos and how to get started, because you really, you know, are setting the tone for us to have an amazing 2023, and we definitely appreciate that.
Well, thank you for having me in the guest seat.
Yes, in the spotlight. So with that being said, I mean, we've been getting a lot of great tips, and I want to have some more fun. I know you guys want to have some fun as well. And so it brings me to our next segment, which is new, and it's called This or That. Tara, tell them how it works.
All right. So this one is a lot like Fact or Fiction, where I will launch a poll, but this time your job is to decide this or that, and I'll give you a category. So we'll start, and Kim and Nathan, I want to hear from you as well. You guys get your polling fingers ready. Our first this or that. Would you rather wrap the presents or decorate the tree?
I guess I'll go first.
Go ahead.
I'd rather decorate the tree. Because wrapping presents, it's a task. Because when I wrap a present, they won't want it. Because I suck at wrapping presents. But decorating a tree, you can get so creative and lighten it up. So I would definitely decorate the tree.
I would have chosen decorate the tree. We had we were supposed to wrap presents this morning, and I didn't volunteer. I didn't want to be kicked out. So yes, I'm not very good. I'm a Christmas bag girl. I will throw everything in the Christmas bag. So what about you, Tara?
See, and I am complete opposite.
Really?
I love decorations. I love to look at them. Mm. I hate physically doing it. It's so much work. I would rather wrap presents all day long, because you get into a rhythm, right? And you don't really have to think about it unless you have a weird shaped box, which I had a few of those with the kids that I give to. So that is, oh, wow. These are fun. So we are almost even split, 51-49.
Wow.
But 51% would rather wrap presents. And we are in the chat. Shanisha makes her own bows.
Oh, well, I'm going to have to write that down. So Nathan, we already know, we'll decorate Tara's tree. Tara will wrap our presents, and then we'll get a homemade bow.
Great. How about our next this or that? Let's go for, would you rather drink eggnog or hot chocolate?
Hot chocolate.
Eggnog.
Eggnog?
I love eggnog.
Me too. She just doesn't love me.
I mean, I hear that quite a bit. But you guys, our consensus is right. He just says both if they have extra. So
both. Both. Oh yeah, I'm gonna do both. I would go with both.
I also agree with you guys. I am hot chocolate all the way. But the chat, well, the poll is actually hot chocolate as well, 71%-29%.
Woohoo.
Yeah. But Shanisha says she can only do a glass of either. So not too much of it.
Exactly.
All right. How about our next this or that? We have, would you rather travel for the holidays or stay home?
Oh, stay home.
stay home. Because I'd rather stay home just because it's so homey. It's like being in my comfort zone. And
I don't want to be at the airport with canceled flights. That's the only reason why I said stay home. Now, after Christmas, I am on the next flight out. But yeah, not during the holidays. What about you, Tara? Well, you're taking a flight. So,
well, that's my problem is if I am doing the holidays kind of on my own in my own little, you know, my little bubble, my family, my close-knit family is myself and my dog. So if I were doing that, I would love to travel. But problem is I already travel. I just travel home to where my family is because I live completely different from they are. So I kind of get a little bit of both, I guess.
Right.
And it looks like our audience is with us. 78% of them would rather stay home. Talking about those Christmas movies on Hallmark, of course. Everybody just says travel when it's not the holidays.
Right.
And or maybe travel a few days before, but I'm with you on the canceled flights. It's a little scary.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
It's a little scary. All right, you guys, let's go for number four. We've got this or that. Would you rather wear? Oops. And I clicked the wrong button. Excuse me. Here we go. Would you rather wear an ugly sweater or would you rather dress up nice for the holidays?
Oh, well, I'm going to be doing a lot of eating, so I'm going to go ahead with the sweater. Nobody wants to eat a ton of food dressed up. Well, at least not me.
Yeah, well, I'm with you because and ugly sweaters are fun. Mm-hmm. So it's like setting that fun
tone. It's stretchy.
Yeah, it's stretchy. That is true.
I think today of all days, since we are in South Louisiana, I would probably rather be dressed up nice right now than in this sweater because it's a little warm.
True.
But our audience is actually pretty split. We've got 55% for an ugly sweater and 45% for dress up nice. Ooh, and Diana, today's your birthday? Well, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. And if you are referring to Christmas being your birthday, she said she would rather dress up for that, and I totally agree.
I agree.
Oh, Christmas Day. Wow, what a birthday. All right, our last this or that. Let's get one more for you guys. Ooh, and this can spark some debate, this one. Would you guys rather watch Die Hard or Home Alone? And I'll add a bonus in there. Is Die Hard considered a Christmas movie? Either. Are they considered Christmas movies to you?
Well, I'm up for debate on the Home Alone being a Christmas movie because that is my fave. I still watch it and still laugh like it's my first time watching it. So you guys, with that being said, you guys already know which one I'm choosing, which is Home Alone. I've never seen Die Hard, so I can't comment on that.
Yeah, I was going to say I haven't seen Die Hard, so Home Alone is my choice by default.
Y'all have some homework to do.
Yes.
I don't know. I think I would probably want to do a little movie marathon and maybe watch both.
Mm-hmm.
It does seem like most of the chat agrees that Die Hard is a Christmas movie. So I am with you all on that one today. It gets quite, you know, the debate often. But we do have Home Alone is the winner at 69%. But we do have a few add-in Christmas movies if you're interested.
Yes.
We've got The Sound of Music, which I never thought as a Christmas movie. But it does happen around the holidays.
It does.
We've got, Terry says both movies are a must during the holidays. We've got Scrooged, Charlie Brown Christmas, White Christmas, Christmas Carol. I could keep going. There are so many. Elf and Polar Express. Now, I forget about Polar Express.
Right. Yeah. I know Jenny was talking about It's a Wonderful Life and Miracle on 34th Street. That's a staple in her home, she said. So, all right. Well, this was fun. I love having fun, especially around this time. And I guess we got to know a lot about each other.
Right.
So it's a win-win. And so, you know, it's all about being grateful, even for the things, even for hot chocolate and eggnog, for our Christmas movies and travel and seeing family. Those are all things that, you know, could be on our gratitude list. And we're also grateful for those of you that, you know, serve the citizens of Louisiana. And that brings us to our next segment, which is our Success Series Salute. Tara?
Yeah, now I know you guys are all familiar with our Success Series Salute. And this quarter, we really wanted to just highlight all of you that have been nominated thus far this year. I really want to shout out you guys. We are grateful for your continued participation in our webinars. We are grateful for your nominations. And what this shows to us is that each and every one of these nominees go above and beyond, and your coworkers are grateful that you go above and beyond for your state every day for every citizen. And I just have to say that means a lot. And so shout out to all of our 2022 Success Series Salute nominees. We are grateful for you.
We are definitely grateful for you guys. So thank you for submitting those nominations. And so I can't believe you guys that, you know, we're almost at the end of this episode of 2022. You know, we've, you know, talked a lot about gratitude. And I think one of the things that, you know, I'm taking away from this conversation is, I mean, you guys promoted those gratitude journals. And I'm sure Tara and I will be on Amazon as soon as this ends, or as soon as we get home, we're going to go order our gratitude journals. Do you have any closing thoughts in regards to gratitude, Nathan?
Yes, I know it's easy to be in this grateful mood during the holidays, but let's try our best to be grateful year round. Right. Let's practice gratitude throughout the whole year just to stay in that space and not be Scrooges in March.
Exactly. Exactly. What about you, Tara? Any closing thoughts in regards to gratitude?
Yes, but it's so hard for me to put into all of the words. I just have to, you're right. It's so easy to be grateful during the holidays, but it's that reminder, you know, in June, in July,
right?
To think about the same things. And I guess in the theme of thanking everyone, I do want to thank you too, and our team, and just everyone involved in the Success Series, which includes our audience, of course, for that reminder to be grateful and for that reminder, because I'll tell you, until we started planning for this webinar, what am I grateful for? I don't know. It's not something that I sat with very often. So I'm glad I got the opportunity.
Mm-hmm. And something else, you know, we want your feedback. And I have a couple of questions for you guys. And the first one is, you know, what do you guys think about the changes that we've made for this Success Series? And if you wouldn't mind, you know, putting that in chat, you know, what did you guys think about the new format? And, you know, 2023 is around the corner. And so we want to know, what are some topics that you guys would like to see in 2023? Nathan, you have like a specific topic that you're looking, that you're thinking you want to cover next year?
You know, the way I'm feeling now, I'd rather do a part two on gratitude next December. This should be every year.
Right. I you know what, that is another good idea, and we're going to be brainstorming, and so, you know, we want your input as well. Gratitude is something that, you know, can be a part of it, even if we don't dedicate an entire episode, just keeping that, and, you know, into the forefront. Tara, do you have any specific topics that you're brainstorming that you'd like to see in 2023?
Oh, there are so many. And something that I think we brought up, but we didn't quite talk about yet, was informal leadership. And also, I would love to do a series or a conversation on informal leadership, so leading without a title, and maybe just maybe about being a good follower as well, because we don't need everyone to be leaders all the time.
Right.
So when do you be a leader and when do you be a follower? I would love to know that for myself.
Right.
Absolutely.
So we love to hear your feedback, you guys. So keep on typing in chat and keep those coming. Any, you know, comments that, you know, or changes you would like, or we just want your feedback. Okay. We really appreciate you guys, you know, spending the year with us, listening, sharing everything. You guys have been amazing. Yes. Nathan and Tara and I, we have grown so much because of you. And, you know, we are definitely grateful for you guys as well as our amazing team. Anything, any other comments you want to make, Nathan, before we end?
I just want to wish everyone happy holidays. I hope you guys are safe and just enjoy them. Spend time in that grateful space. Since we set the mood, let's be in a grateful mood for the holidays.
Right. And if you're having any Christmas parties, Nathan, I, and Tara, we don't mind getting invites. So Tara, do you have anything?
The problem with getting invites is I might actually show up.
Yes.
I just want to say thank you all for joining us and being great conversationalists and being so respectful of each other as we go through this. I also want to share a happy holidays to all of you and any holiday you may be celebrating, as well as just a quick note that once this is through, I will leave the chat open just a little bit longer, get that holiday music going again. So any feedback you would love to share with us, we would love to hear it.
Thank you, Tara. All right, you guys. We know that you are ready to go and enjoy your holiday season. Don't forget during that time, as well as that time until you see our next episode, to keep on learning. Happy holidays, you guys. Bye.
Bye.